Good afternoon all. Today in this video, we'll be learning how to make a control arm. This is a drawing of a control arm. Welcome to CSCAD Technologies. We'll be making this model using CATIA as the CAD tool. First, trying to understand the drawing. As you can see, there are two views provided to us. This is the front view and this is the top view. The section view is cut at this location to give us a better understanding of these cuts as well as the hole in the feature. Apart from this, there is also a detail view which shows a detailed description about the pattern and the feature which is present over here. So we will be seeing how to make this model one step after step by step, and we will be using part module in your CATIA. Now, let's begin by making your part design. First, we do know that there is a circle of 100 dia which is added up to 40. So let's try to take that. We know very well how to use add the material. So we are adding the material with 100 dia. On equal sides, because I have everything with respect to the center, so I am adding it symmetrically, so it will be easy for me to later on mirror the features. For example, I have this cut only till 4. I can mirror it onto the opposite side if I make a symmetrical addition of material. Now I want to do 40, so 20 is fine with mirrored event. This will be your 20. Now, this plate, whatever you are trying to see, which is adjoining to the 40, which is adjoining to the 60 dia circle, is actually only of 22 length, 22 depth. So I'd like to use the pad command and first make that and then later do the circle by using my references. Now, understanding this is my top view. I'll take a circle in a construction format first. The diameter of that is supposed to be 60 and the distance from the center is 110. Now, I'll take this as well as my reference. Now, I can join lines using line tangent because they are tangently maintained with respect to the circle anyway. So I am using line tangent in between this as well as this. Similarly, I will do the same thing to the other side. We will keep whatever is necessary and trim off whatever is not. So from here, I have a circle which usually starts from here, ends over here. Same way, I have a circle which starts at the center, starts over here and ends over there. Once I exit, again I am trying to add it symmetrically with respect to the center, but up to 22. So if it's 22, I have to give 11 and then it adds up to 22. Now, same way, now I'm trying to add the circle which is of 60. Yeah, let me try to add 60 as well. This is my reference. I don't have to redo the sketch again. I can just keep this and then make a circle directly, considering the center and then making the circle. Sorry. Making it concentric. Now, this is supposed to be added on both the sides up to 20, which is exactly as 40, which is already provided in the drawing. Next, now, to make this shape, we first require this location. This is the reference to make the 51, the angle reference. Now, so for that, let us try to make this circle first and then proceed ahead with the rest of the part. So, to remove material, again, we can use a pocket command. I'd like to remove material in this direction, and all the details are provided to me, which is this dia is actually supposed to be, this internal dia is supposed to actually be 44. As you can see, it's supposed to be 44. Now, the distance is at a distance of 20 mm from the center. So let me try to give 20 from the center. This particular feature is actually cut till 4. So I'll just cut the material till 4. I can mirror this onto the opposite side. Now when I take a section view, I'll have the cuts on both the sides as you can see. This is the top cut, this is the bottom cut. Now, continuing. The whole shape of this plate is actually 22. So we can actually directly add the material to 22 by taking this as the reference, which is the center plane as my reference. Now, considering the top view again, this is my first reference whichever we have taken right now. From here, I have a center line which is actually This is the first one, and I have it in between this point and a certain distance. Now, the angle in between this as well as this is 51. It's already provided in the drawing. Now, let us try to finish by actually taking that 50 dia circle. And we do have 127 as well. Let's try to give 127 from this point to this point is 127. Almost close. Now, again, I'll be using this as my reference because I need those tangent lines to create the shape, these lines. Instead of doing it multiple times, I can directly take by tangent line. It's a little easier for me. Same way onto this side as well. Now, I'll use the arc to create the circle with respect to this center, because that circle is with respect to that center. Now, trim off whatever is not required for us and then try to add the material. This is actually not required. This is my closed profile. Once I exit, it will automatically ask you how much do you want. I want it mirrored even to 22. That is 11 on either sides. There are few cuts which we can see in the section view. As you can see, these cuts. These cuts are of 10 typical, that is, it is maintaining the material is left, the material in between is 10, and above this area as well as this area, we are supposed to remove the material. So to do that, let me try to take a reference or create a plane at 10 distance. Now, I can take a point anywhere I like and then I can mirror it onto the opposite side. Let me try to coincide it in the center so I don't have to constrain it over and over again. Now, the distance between these two is provided to us as 10. I am using these as the reference for the cuts. Now, I can take a plane parallel to the point. The reference is this. It has to pass through this point. Now, we will try to remove this shape of the existing body. So, we can directly use a pocket command. Make it on the plane which we have recently taken. And we can use our references as well. This is my reference. This is my reference. And we can create an offset only of this edge. This is supposed to be 10. Similarly, I can do this on the other side as well. Give it as 10. Now, I'll take whatever I need and keep it inside the feature. Remove whatever is not needed and exit. Now, to remove the material, we need it into the other direction and up to the next. So, this way we can maintain 10 dimension and we have removed the material as well. Now, we can mirror this onto the opposite side with respect to the center plane over here and then keep it onto the other side as well. Now, the same cut is made over here. So, let's try to take pocket as well for that too on the plane which we have recently made. Again, sketch on the plane which we have recently made. I'm trying to take an offset on both the sides. This is offsetted to 10. This is offsetted to 10 as well. Now, this is my reference, so I can take a circle with respect to this. So I'll keep it in a construction format and then make a circle in keeping in line with this and create this circle. I'll later trim off whatever is not needed for me and then project this face as well. Now, whatever is not needed can be trimmed by simply using your trim command. Now, let's try to do that. This is the cut which we are supposed to make. Again, it has to be done up to next, and I can mirror this with respect to the center plane onto the other side. I can mirror this pocket with respect to the center plane onto the other side. Now, we have various type of holes as well which we can give. So before that, let's try to cut this shape on this face. Again, I'm trying to take a pocket command. Now, there are references which we can use for this, which is R40. We can take this center as the reference, but for R25, this is the reference. So again, I'm trying to take a circle from here and say this is supposed to be R40. And taking with respect to this as well. Let me try to take this as a reference and take a circle exactly at the center. Give it R25. It has to maintain concentricity, so let me try to maintain concentricity as well. Now, there is a line which is located over here, so let's try to take that line as well. I like to do it on one side and then mirror it onto the other. So I'm just taking a line like this, and then the mirror actually of this will be a copy. The distance between these two is supposed to be 10, so I'd like to take that as 10. Let's trim off whatever is not needed and keep whatever is necessary for us, as we can see. Again, I'm using a trim command. I'd like to trim this face off. And this as well as this. This is my reference, so I'll keep it as the reference. This is the cut which we are supposed to make. The cut is actually supposed to be through, so I'll give it up to next and it will cut through the next. Again, we can mirror this with respect to the center plane onto the other side. It creates a perfect mirror onto the other side. Now, proceeding with the holes. We have different types of holes. For example, over here we have a hole which is of 30 through. Let me try to maintain concentricity first and then give 30 through. Supposed to be 30 up to next. Now, there is also another hole over here which is 21 through, so again I'd be using the same hole command and again maintain concentricity with respect to the arc or the circle, take 21 and give up to next. Now there is a pattern, as you can see over here, on 30 PCD with 6 dia. So on this, let me try to take the sketch. Take this as my center, actually, reference, and then take a circle with respect to the center. Let me move this away. Take it with respect to the center. The diameter for this is actually supposed to be 30. Now, the pattern is actually lying on the 30 diameter circle. So let me try to coincide that on the 30 diameter circle, and then it should be in line with the center face. This is the hole I'm trying to make. So once I exit, it'll ask me for the dimension. I can give 6 and then say up to next. It takes that picture. Again, to create a pattern, you can use circular pattern. How many copies do we require is what we are supposed to decide. We require 7 copies, so I'm taking it as 7 with respect to this as the reference. Once I say okay, it drills all the 7. Last but not the least, there are rounds as usual. First one is actually of R5. By default, the dimension is taken as R5. So let me continue with the R5s. Okay, I'm sorry. These are all of R5, and these two are of R5 as well. These two as well as these two. Of course, I cannot mirror them, so I'm doing it in one attempt. I'm trying not to hit escape this time. So this is R5. Now there's another one which is R15, which is in the coincident location over here. So let me try to take that and give R15. It takes R15. This is your control arm using CATIA. If you are interested in learning further more advanced level of CATIA, you can contact us. Our details are given in the description below. Please like and subscribe our channel. We require your support so we can post more videos like this for your better understanding. Thank you.